Hey, what's up everybody? This is Rodney Walker with MCA Emergency Roadside Assistance. And you've probably seen other MCA videos where people are showing you how to market with postcards, but this is something different because it's not only is it going to be cheaper, but it's also going to be easier. The process of the different things you have to do to put your postcard together to go out in the mail is much easier, okay? Now, I know you guys have heard a lot of different things about targeted leads. People are saying that you need to buy leads, buy a lead sheet, which means you go to some company or you go to some individual and you order a sheet that has a bunch of names on it that are supposed to be targeted leads. Well, in my opinion, there's really no such thing as a targeted lead. Yes, I have made money with postcard marketing in the past, but it's really not enough. It's really not something that I see as a big significant difference in my income. So I'm trying something different, and I believe this is going to be the source that's going to be able to not only blow up the company as far as our appearance and professionalism, but it's also going to be something that can put more money in the pockets of yourself, of you guys, okay? Now, today I'm going to teach you guys about what's called every door direct mail. Every door direct mail is something that has been put together by the United States Postal Service, okay, the post office or whatever you want to call it. It's a much simpler and cheaper way of marketing with postcards. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at what we have here, okay? Here's the USPS website, all right? This is the United States Post Office website, okay? And if you go over here under where it says business, you'll see something called Every Door Direct Mail, all right? I'm gonna go ahead and click there, okay? What you'll see come up is a map that gives you the option of going ahead and putting in your zip code or the area you live in. So I'm gonna put in my zip code as an example, and then click on search. I'm gonna let that process. And then what it's gonna do, it's gonna look for all the different postal routes for my zip code. My zip code is 34746. So what it's gonna do is the system's gonna pick up all of the different postal routes. Okay, everybody, there's many different postal carriers in a zip code, and so we see it's finished. So now these are all the different routes. Okay, now this is something that can be done for residential or business, but I suggest that you just do it for residential. So if I was to click on residential, I can select residential only. Okay, and it's going to make a few changes. You can also separate things by the age group. Right now I have it set on 25, people are 25 to 45 years old, and that's what it's showing, but you can adjust it to whatever you want it to be, okay? Now, if you guys look, it says this is the total number of homes that my postcard will go out to in this actual route. So route H002 has 423 homes. Okay, route H003 has 440 homes, okay? And then you can also see like the average income of these people that live in that area. And then you can also see how much it's gonna cost you to send out the postcards. So if I wanted to send out 423 postcards, it's gonna cost me $77.41, okay? Now, let me explain to you how this works. So the first thing we gotta know is where to get our postcards, all right? Now, call them postcards, some people call them flyers, whatever you wanna call it. But what you'll do is you'll go over to my website, let's go ahead and take a look, which is going to be mcashop.com. When you go over to mcashop.com, you can go ahead and come down and you can pick the different postcard that you want. Okay, I have many different ones, but the one I'm going to show you now is this one here. So if you guys look over here, this is the one I just ordered. I've ordered 5,000 of these, as you see in the box over here. Okay, I've ordered 5,000 of these postcards. All right, so this is a postcard that's for the benefits only. This is not a business opportunity postcard. Now, on the back, as you guys see, it has the MCA logo. It says benefits on reverse side, which is right here. And then it says unlimited roadside assistance, my website, etc. but it also has what's called a indicia, okay? This is something that has to be on the postcard to do every door direct mail. So its postage is already paid, okay? Because you'll pay for your postage through the website or at the post office, okay? It's much easier to just go ahead and pay for it on the website if you have a bank card or credit card or debit card. And then as you see, is it says local postal customer. So bottom line is you don't have to put a stamp on this. You don't have to put a stamp here. You don't have to print out leads. You don't have to put a label on each one of these postcards. This is much easier because you're gonna save a lot of work. Now, when you're using stamps, okay, let's say that you wanna send out 1,000 postcards. When you're using stamps, to get a postcard stamp from the United States Postal Service, it's gonna run you 35 cents, which is up 1 cent since last year. Last year was 34 cents. They have now raised the price to 35 cents, and they'll probably keep going. When you're sending out a postcard through every door direct mail, you're only gonna be paying about 18 and a half cents. So you're saving a lot of money by going the route with every door direct mail. So again, this eliminates the need, one, for you to go buy stamps. You don't have to go out and buy 1,000 stamps at 35 cents a piece. You don't have to then take each stamp and put it on each postcard, which can take a lot of time. You don't have to look up what's called hot leads or targeted leads. Now let's talk about that for a second. Now, who can prove that these leads are targeted? I can't, and neither can you. We're all just going off the fact that somebody told us that these leads are targeted. These leads are hot. These are people who are interested in business opportunities. How do you know that these are targeted leads? Just because some individual said they're targeted leads? I mean, anybody can make up a lead company. I could start a lead company right now and just off my popularity, probably make a couple $1,000 a week if I wanted to. Anyone can start what's called hot leads or targeted leads, but at the end of the day, nobody can really prove that those targeted leads are, you know, haven't been recycled, and you know, the same leads are not being passed around to the same, you know, different sales agents in the same companies. So to me, it's more valuable to go out and try to reach the people with the benefits of MCA, not necessarily the business opportunity. You can use the business opportunity for this also. But for me right now, I'm targeting people, just random individuals who may need roadside assistance. By us providing such an awesome service, I believe that everybody needs our services at one point or another in time. And so this is a very easy way to get the services out to the people. Now, again, you can use this for the business opportunity. So again, I don't have to buy postage. I don't have to put a stamp on each one. I don't have to buy a bunch of address labels that have, you know, a bunch of sheets, and there's like 1,000 address labels, and, you know, buy lead sheets that come to my house, and then I gotta get the leads put on the address labels, and then I have to go from there and put each one on the postcard. I don't have to do all of that. All I have to do is use the Every Door Direct Mail system, send out the postcards about our great benefits, and then when the people call, talk to them on the phone, be professional, and close the sale. Or they can just go to my website. So this is I think this will work better for people. Instead of going out buying leads, I think you should use the Every Door Direct Mail system. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna walk you guys through exactly how this is gonna work. I'm gonna go ahead and log into my account. You will need to set up an account with the United States Postal Service. It's free of charge. You just put in your basic information, create a username and password. So let's go ahead and take a look. Now, when you're doing the Every Door Direct Mail, you can do it in bundles of 50 or bundles of 100. Well, why would you do 50? You know, you might as well go ahead and just do bundles of 100. If you're sending out to a route that has 300 or 400 or 500 people, then you might as well just do bundles of 100. Now, the first thing you wanna do is, after you get your postcards, the postcard design from my website or wherever you get postcards from, after you get them printed and sent back to your home, if you want to get postcards printed, you can check out 5stargraphics.com. All you have to do is send them the design. send an email to info@firestargraphics.com, and then they're going to send you an invoice. Just pay for it, and then they'll ship the flyers in your house in a box like this one over here. Okay, you'll get a big box of 5,000. Now, 5,000 flyers or postcards is going to run you anywhere between $125 to $150. It depends on where you live because of the shipping. Okay? Once you get your postcards in, you want to start to bundle them in 100. Now, here's how this works. The first thing you want to do is get you a master bundle. Master bundle. So, what I do is I have a sheet here. This is my master sheet. And this is 100. So this is called a bundle of 100. You never ever want to get rid of your master bundle. You never want to take your master bundle and actually ship it out. Especially if you plan on running through 5,000 and then order another 5,000, never get rid of your master bundle. Because your master bundle is going to be the one that you compare all the other flyers to actually add up to 100. Let me show you what I mean by that. All of these are 100. Okay, so let me show you how this works. I've got my master bundle here. Okay, now how do I count out 100 and make it simple? Well, I got 100 here. I counted out 50. So let's just say this is 50. I counted out 50 and then I put another 50 right next to it, and then that's 100. Okay, but you want to make sure that they're about as accurate as possible. So I'm going to grab some flyers. Okay. I'm gonna stick them here. As you can see, that's a little smaller. Well, my master bundle has more. You see that? Okay, so I need more on that side. So I'll grab a couple more. Make sure they're tight. Press down and hit them together. Well, that's exactly 100. Watch what happens when I remove this one. See, my master bundle is going over that one. So that's 99 now. So I'm gonna put this one back on here. Okay, put them together, and that's about 100, okay? It can be 99, it can be 100, it can be 101. It's not really a big deal, right? So now, that's how I know I have 100. So I'll just take that stack, boom, I got 100 stack. Same thing, so on and so on. You just keep grabbing them, and you compare them to your master bundle. But remember, never get rid of your master bundle. That's the mistake I made, is that when I took my first 500 to the post office, I took my master bundle, and then when I came home, I had to do it again. I had to count out another 100. So you don't want to get rid of your master bundle. So always just put a sheet like this and say master on it. That way you'll know to always leave it alone. Okay? Now, let's go over here to the website. I'm going to walk you through exactly how this works. I'm going to have all these designs. These designs are all going to have the indicia on the back of them. Okay? So I haven't updated the website yet. But you have to have this, and you have to have this. All right, so it'll be on the back. Basically, this design is going to be on the back of all the flyers. Okay, so just give me a few days, and I'm going to go ahead and get that taken care of. But if you want this design, I've already got this taken care of. Okay, but if you want the other designs, it's going to take me a day or two to get these set up. Now, all you do, again, the instructions are here. You just go to email info@firestargraphics.com. They're going to go ahead and send you an invoice. You send over your graphic to them, and then they'll send you an invoice for you to pay. And all you got to do is use your PayPal account or your Visa MasterCard. Now, let's go to the website, the United States Post Office. I'm going to log into my account. Now, I've already logged in. When you go to a create account, it'll be up here. You just put in all your basic information. Now, I'm going to show you guys how exactly this works. So we're going to let that process for a second. It's looking for the routes. And keep in mind, guys, you don't have to worry about the size. The size works. One of the things that I was having a problem with was actually getting the right size. I've already done that for you. I've already taken two bundles in. They've already verified that the size is perfect. And I actually just spoke to the mail carrier who brought my mail today. And she said, this is perfect. She said, it's fine. So the size is already set. Okay, so we're good on the size. Now, I pulled up the routes here, okay? Bring that in closer. All right, so I'm gonna pick a route. I'm gonna pick this first one. I'm gonna pick this one. Let's just pick this one right here. So For $107.60, I can send out 588 postcards. I'm gonna go ahead and click continue. All right, I'm gonna send these out today, just an example. You can pick whatever date you want. Make sure you check on here, I've read terms and service, etc. Okay? And then I can either pay at the post office or I can pay online. Pay at post office, wait a minute, check services, okay. Pay at the post office, wait a minute, 13th, okay. Pay at the post office. Now, we're gonna go down here, and then there's some paperwork that you have to fill out. I'm gonna show you guys how to fill out the paperwork. So the first thing you wanna do is click on, actually you can just go right here. You can click on print all forms, okay? All right, I'm gonna go ahead and print these forms and I'm gonna show you what they are. Let me show you guys how this works. This is just a receipt, you keep this. When you go into the post office, you can show it to them. You don't have to show them either or. You just keep that. All right, this is something that has to be filled out. I'm gonna show you guys how to fill this out. It's very simple. This one you take with you, okay? But you do not have to do anything with it, all right? You just take it and you give it to them. And then this is the facelift, all right? Now I'm gonna need more facelifts, right? Because my order was for 588. So I'm gonna need 6 facelifts, okay? So I got one here, that means I need 5 more. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to print, what is this, page 4? 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is page 4, okay? And I'm gonna print 2, 3, 4, 5 more copies. So let me print 5 more copies of the facelift. And then I'm going to print those, and then I'm going to fill these out with you guys and show you guys exactly what to do. This is a simple process that actually stressed my brain for a couple months, but I'm walking you through everything, okay? All right, so we got 6 facelifts here, all right? The first thing we're going to fill out is this sheet here. Now let me get the pen. Let me get the pen. Hello, hello, where's the pen? Oh, there it is. All right, now, let's set the computer to the side, and then maybe you can bring the camera around here and just see how I do it. Okay, make sure this is right and fine. Okay, now, this has my company name, okay? My phone number. You don't have to fill any of this out. Okay, hold up 1 second. Okay, you don't have to fill any of that out. That's just basically your name and address. Don't fill this out. The only thing you're gonna need to fill out on this paper is where it says total number of bundles. For me, that's gonna be 6 bundles, 588. 100 bundles a piece, and then the 88. That will be 6, okay? Total number of pieces per bundle, you're just gonna put 100, all right? Even though you have that one that has 88 in it, don't worry about that, just put 100 here. And then you're gonna check this box here that says type of postage, you're gonna do EDDM retail. Just put an X there or a check there, that's all you gotta do. Something else you're supposed to do is where it says weight, but we don't know how much these weigh. They'll figure that out. What they're gonna do when you get to the post office is once you take in all your bundles, they're gonna take a loose one, okay? Take one that's not in your bundle because what they're gonna do is weigh it. The weight is fine. I've already checked on this twice, like I said, but they're gonna need one to put on the scale and then they'll fill in how much it weighs. So you don't even have to worry about doing that, okay? And so other than that, don't worry about the weight. And then that's it. All you do is sign here. I'm gonna sign my name. Print my name. And then put my number. That's it. That sheet is done. You don't have to worry about that. Remember, this sheet, all you do is take it with you. You don't even have to do nothing with this. This sheet right here is just your receipt. Now, what we must fill out is our facelifts. Okay, now I'm gonna walk you through how to do this. You need a facelift for each bundle. Okay, so this is how it's done. We're gonna put today's date, which is 11/13/2015. Total number of pieces, 100. Total number of bundles. This is bundle one of six, because I need six bundles. So then this sheet will go with one of my bundles, okay? So let's flip that over, the smaller one. 11/13/2015, total number of pieces, 88. Remember, we did 588 pieces, so those all have 100 per bundle. This is the final one, and it has 88 pieces, okay? Total number of bundles, bundle six of six. That's it. Okay? So now, what we got to do is we got to get 100 per bundle, and we got to attach these. This is what you're going to do. So here's a bundle of 100. You're going to take this like this, put it here, take your slip, fold it in half first, like that. Fold it in half, crease it, and then you're going to fold it right at the edge of this barcode, okay? So we're gonna do like that. Don't have to be perfect, okay? Boom. Now we folded that. Set it on top, get you some rubber bands, okay? You see I got rubber bands here. Get you some rubber bands, and then you're going to grab it like this. Go ahead and loop it on there. Depending on the type of rubber bands you have, it's going to depend on if you should do it once or twice. You don't want it to be too tight, because then it's going to warp. It's going to bend your flyers or your postcards. I think, see, that's kind of sliding. So I'm going to go ahead and loop it again. Okay? We'll do it like that. Make sure the rubber band is off of the barcode, just in the middle. You're done. That's bundle one. Bundle one is done. We're gonna grab bundle two. Same thing. We're gonna fold it. Fold it again. And then make sure you have number two or six on top. Get you the rubber bands. Okay. This is so simple, guys. You don't have to put a bunch of stamps on each postcard. You don't have to put a label on each postcard. This is so simple. This is where the money is going to be, because we're going to advertise our company and let people know what we do. That's bundle two. Okay, same thing. Three. In fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just go ahead and fold all these real quick. It can be faster. That's bundle three. Bundle four. Okay. Five. And you don't have to do 500. If you can't afford it, don't do it. You do whatever you can afford, guys. Some of the routes are small, so you can do smaller routes. Now, okay, so let me finish this off. All right, we're folding them all. I don't want to confuse you guys. I hope I haven't confused you by going out of order like that. Now, we have everything folded, so let's go ahead and attach these. This is bundle five or six. I mean, it should be self-explanatory at this point. Make sure again, okay, that's four or six. Make sure that's showing. Go ahead and put on the rubber band. Loop it up. Get another bundle. Here's three of six. Rubber band. Okay, so we got one, two, three, four. Let's keep going. Almost done. Oh, make sure you put the slip on there. Okay. That's good. And then finally, now, remember, we only need 88. We only need 88 in our last one. Remember, because it's not 100. Okay? So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to simply just take two decks, put them next to each other. These are about 100. Okay? And then I'm going to take off 12. 100 minus 12 will be 88. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So that's about 88. Okay? So then I'm going to go ahead and take that deck. Same thing. Attach the facelift. And by the way, guys, it doesn't matter if you have it on this side or this side. That's a question I ask. You can put the facelift on this side or on this side. It's irrelevant. It doesn't really matter. Just in case anybody's wondering. Boom. Now, that's it. We're done. Okay? So now, I've got bundles 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. All I'm going to do is I'm just going to take these to the post office, stand in a long line. So if you can get to the post office as early as possible, like as soon as they open, the better, so you don't have to stand in line. Just take them, put them in a bag, put them in a box. Make sure you take your sheets with you. Make sure you take this slip here. You don't have to do anything. Remember, all you're going to do is fill out the total number of bundles, how many per bundle. And then you're going to check where it says EDDM Retail Indicia, sign, print, and put your phone number, and that's a wrap. That's all you got to do. You can take this if you want to. I don't think you need to, but just take it, and then you just take it up there. Now, if you paid online, set up an account and paid online, you're going to get another receipt, okay? You're going to get another receipt that will basically show how much you paid. And then, so you just take that with you if you want. But once they scan this, they'll know that you made a payment anyway. All right, but just take it with you. And but if you didn't pay online, you'll just pay them at the post office with your cash or Visa, MasterCard, and that's it. And so now you're sending out however many flyers you can to people about MCA roadside assistance services. When people call, make sure you answer the phone. And please, please, this is so important. If you're going to do this for the benefits like me, you can't have a website that says something like makemoneywithj.com or something like that. You're advertising the benefits. So if you want to buy a website, a URL, you need to make sure it's something just geared towards MCA, period. It can't be about making money. It can't be about making cash or anything like that, because that doesn't make sense and it won't match up. You can't advertise the benefits and then have a website address talking about making money, okay? So make sure you get a website address that's about just the company, period. Make sure if it's about the benefits, then your website matches about the benefits. Okay, guys? So then that's it. You just take the flyers, the postcards to the post office, give it to them, then they'll get them out on the route. And then what happens is they just put these in everybody's mailbox on that route. Make sure you try this process, because I believe it's going to be a gold mine for us and for the company. All right. Peace.